Epilepsy
Today!
Here we are! And we've got some good news!
We've got great news!
We've got good news! Do you want to start off with this one?
No.
Margaux, since you seem to have, you know, a real propensity for this.
Please don't go there. I'm a preschool teacher.
I know you are, and nobody would have known if you hadn't said that. Okay. Representative Scott Perry, he's a Republican, and he's from PA, Pennsylvania. Okay.
Yeah, like something against the Republicans?
No, no, no. I find it kind of, I wouldn't expect, you know, they're kind of.
Oh, conservative.
Conservative, yeah.
Yeah, this is a little bit out of the box.
Somebody's conservative.
Yeah.
It's, okay. He has introduced the Charlotte's Web Medical Hemp Act of 2014, and that's House of Representatives 5226. So I think you can actually look it up online that way and get the whole bill, okay, and see what it's completely about. And basically, what it is about is to remove therapeutic hemp from the Controlled Substances Act and expand the availability of this important treatment option so that people who are not getting any kind of response from anti-epileptic medications, and there's a percentage of young children out there who continue to have seizures on a very, very regular basis. Some of these children are even having seizures continuously. So they've got that electrographic impulse taking place, that release of electrographic energy taking place all the time. When that is happening, it makes it very difficult for that child to make any kind of strides as far as their developmental steps are concerned.
Right.
Okay. Because there's all this dysfunction in the child's brain.
Right.
So what they're trying to do is they're trying to get this legalized, okay, or to make an exception so that this particular treatment, the CBD, which is the oil, okay, that is being used, okay, to sometimes control very, very difficult types of seizure activity.
And I think you need to, I think that what we have to do as well is discuss the difference, because I think that when we talk about the CBD and we get all involved in talking about the miracle marijuana and whatnot, that the CBD oil is what they're keeping for that medical marijuana, and the THC is being removed. That's why they're trying
exactly.
to take it off of that Controlled Substances Act.
Right.
So they don't get high and have the psychological effects that we associate with smoking marijuana.
Yeah, yeah. So this is, you know, so basically I think part of the problem is that, you know, you think of it as medical marijuana, and people naturally go to, you know, that idea of yeah, people sitting around smoking this stuff. That's not the case with the CBD oil. You know, you could probably, you know, drink this stuff all day or take it all day, and, you know, have absolutely no psychogenic effects from it. You wouldn't get high off of it, regardless of how much of it you consumed.
And it's more about the oil in this. That's what they keep talking about, the oil, the CBD oil. So it's not even like you're smoking it, right? It's just the oil from it.
No. They I think a lot of times what they'll do is they mix it with like an olive oil or something like that, and it's a tincture kind of thing where they might get three or four drops of this at one particular time. And so they're not getting this huge, huge amount of it, but they might take three or four drops three or four times a day.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Well, your point earlier, Tom, before the show, was that you're kind of happy with this because it frees it up and makes it more accessible to research.
Oh, yes.
So then they can verify if it is or isn't working.
Exactly.
And, Tom, you told me once, not too long ago, how many kids have actually taken this Charlotte's Web?
It's a relatively small number. It's under 100 children that are currently using this because they just can't produce this stuff. It isn't like, it isn't like it's a K-12 chemical process. It is a chemical process, but they have to grow the marijuana, then they have to use so many plants in order to extract the CBD oil. So apparently, you know, you need a whole boatload of this of marijuana in order to be able to get to this purified or distilled state.
Okay.
So they can only accommodate so many people. There are people that are on a waiting list to just try the CBD oil from the Charlotte's Web because it's a specific strain of marijuana.
Now, when we talked about CBD in prior shows, where did they get the information to even think about moving forward with it in the States? Like, is this something that we've been working on in the States, or is it something that they saw maybe being tried, or there being a trial of it in a different country, and they thought maybe we should try it?
Are you wondering who had the nerve to give their kids marijuana in the first place? Because
that's another way.
But it's true. You know, how do people discover stuff, right?
Nothing else is working.
And Charlotte's Web, even though it's the kid story and all that, but the first girl that had success with it was named Charlotte.
That's what I understand. And that's where they came.
They put the Charlotte's Web and tied it in with Let's Help the Kids, or because it is most effective with kids.
Yeah, and that's where it's been used for very young children who have these very, very serious types of seizure activity.
And I think they should probably, you know, add that information as well. Like, I know that it talks about that it's proven for effective in those children, but saying that this is something, like, all of those pieces, so people don't have those views with not having all of the information that kept you throwing your glasses.
Being the kid advocate, we don't want these kids all.
I hope it turns out that you didn't want to see people going down the blind alley, but my gosh,
it was a lot of hype then.
Yeah, and you know, people think, well, you know, if I can't get the CBD oil, I guess what I'll do is I'll just. You know.
But if they do, I mean, and not to say it like that, but it's got to be better than K-Spice. It's got to be better than K-Spice and cinnamon.
Oh, I agree. Everybody knows, you hear about
the K-Spice? Yes, it's the fake marijuana that they have in the, like, in the grocery, well, not the grocery stores,
oh,
but like.
Oh, yeah, that's been, it's been a while since I was reading about that stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe a year ago.
Yeah, but it causes seizures.
Right, on the flip.
Well, and like you were saying earlier too, Margaux, if somebody is growing their own or buying it from somebody, you don't know the fertilizer.
No? You don't know what's in it.
Yeah. I mean, because that's what people are going to do. I can't get the real legal stuff, so, you know, I have my high school kid go out and
score some of this for me.
And then, that could be worse than...
Really what's going on where
you have it in the control group. You know what's going on, and you can have it monitored. And I think that's what needs to happen. Yeah.
You know? And that's my whole objection to it, is that, you know, if, you know, and there are some people who are unscrupulous who will say, I have CBD oil for sale. You know, come and get it. And... it may not, and certainly, you know, if you're not on that list, okay, you're not getting that Charlotte's Web CBD oil. Mm-hmm. You're getting something else. Might be somewhere,
might not.
And maybe light years apart.
And we have to be careful with that, too, because hopefully they won't get into a place where, I mean, I know we have generic drugs, but they don't start cutting back on it because of cost to make it more cost effective for others. And just take out some of those things that would make it successful. You know, just, I think about that, like sometimes we have all of these different medications and the medications are made by different manufacturers and the manufacturers might not be using the same thing, but it's really the same medicine. So to make sure that if they're gonna work towards making sure that this Charlotte's Web
Medical Hemp Act works that we stay true to keeping all of the things
standardized.
To make sure.
Yeah, because even in the, like you're saying, the pharmaceutical industry, my understanding is if you have a generic drug, it can be 10% above.
Yes.
Or 10% below, mm-hmm. which is actually a 20% spread on one batch.
Yeah.
Oh, this month.
Right.
And, and how are you going to keep track of that?
And for some people, that can be disastrous too.
Yeah, I had that happen. I went to have two different, because I'm on Lamictal, and I went to a different pharmacy, and instead of like the diamond one, they gave me the circle one, and the circle Lamictal did not work for me at all.
To me, it seemed like it gave me more seizure activity. Like I didn't have to have that sense. And then when I went to my epileptologist, that's when he was telling me about the different manufacturers and the changes that will make in that. And I never thought about it because you just think, I mean, if you can't, and I guess I should say that Lamictal, well, the generic of the Lamictal, but it can definitely make a difference. So I just hope that people are really devoted and really being an advocate for providing the right type of CBD oil or just that product instead of.
Well, there's always 10% of the population that's trying to beat the system, Margaux.
I know. Me and my utopia.
So
the good news is that the studies are going to go forward, okay, and we're going to actually find out if in fact it does work and how well it works.
And that's what you're excited
and
about.
And that's what I'm excited about, that basically we're going to be doing some controlled scientific research on this.
Well, and definitely, I think with all of this information, too, that's been provided, if you want more information, I would definitely visit the bill and read more about that to educate more of your community, your home.
And if you do feel strongly about this, medical marijuana in Ohio is dead, as far as our governor at the present time is concerned. So that's another issue that you might want to contact your state representative and also your national representatives. As far as, hey, do you want to see this? And if you do want to see this, make sure that your feelings are heard by your representative. On the state and also on the federal level.
With the governor, do you know what his rationale was, or did he make a statement, or
He made the statement that we're not going to see medical marijuana while he's in office. Now he may change, but that's the last thing that I heard. I think I heard that maybe about 3 to 6 months ago.
Okay.
And these people, I think that like families that are dealing with this stuff, like. They are at probably their wits' end.
Oh, they are.
And this, like you said, that I saw in there was a quote that they were pretty much just at their wits' end about what was going to happen, what they should do, and they felt like this gave them hope. So I get how, we have our ideas and perspectives and even judgment on something, but when you think about a family member, I think sometimes that especially when you have someone like that that's in a representative state position, that you have to think about you're taking care of a whole community, everyone. Mm-hmm. So if there's someone that really put yourself in that position, what if you had this son or this daughter or this niece or anything that just could not get the help? Instead of, it's their job, it's all of our job to make sure that we utilize the things that what they're for. But I think that sometimes we get so stuck, like you're saying, about the politics that you're not thinking about the people. And to me personally, people should come before the politics because we're a part of the political piece.
Yeah. Representative Perry was approached by 3 local families whose children suffer from severe epilepsy. Mm-hmm. As a father, I can't imagine how helpless and crestfallen I'd feel to be essentially out of options without any significant way to help my child. And these families live with this circumstance every single day. Mm-hmm. Their heartbreaking situations compelled me to act at the federal level to enable their access to a supplement that literally has changed lives. And there's a little bit more,
But that's, and I think that does does a really nice job of summing up
Yeah.
where we are too, as far as the CBD oil. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So if you certainly if you feel that way, let your representatives know.
Definitely.
Good.